YouTubers. It's Star Trek Enterprise refit update number 22. It's Friday night and I've gone beyond my 5 o'clock curfew and Mama Smurf is not happy. So I'm getting through this because I want to show you a pure technique video. A lot of people say, you know, I talk too much and I wave my hands too much and all that kind of stuff. And I don't show enough when I'm actually working. So this video is strictly technique. What I did is I removed all the masks on the bottom saucer today. If you've seen the tutorial update, you've seen me actually applying them and then painting them. Well, this whole video shows you how I did it. Now, a couple things. I used the X-Acto knife with a broken tip on it. It's just a technique I have. During the film, you'll see me point out to a angled toothpick and that it works. If you're not really adept with an X-Acto knife and you tend to nick the paint, don't do that technique. I've just been handling one, you know, like a drummer for 30 years, and I can kind of have a feel for if I'm digging into the paint or not. And you'll watch through the entire video, I did not nick it. But that's an advanced technique, so you guys use a toothpick, something blunt, whatever, with an angle to it. I always cut a toothpick, and I've showed you this technique at a 45 and get myself a little point on it. You got to go through a lot of toothpicks, which is why I use the X-Acto when I'm trying to do it. But then again, if you start nicking the paint, you don't want to do that, okay? Second thing, there's going to be a lot of interruptions through it and all that, because once in a while, I have to go to the bathroom or something, or take a break, you know, have a drink, whatever, because it is Friday night, and I'm trying to have a good time. So, there was a lot of music playing tonight, Frampton Comes Alive, and all kinds of things, and also a special thank you to Mark Thompson, my Natty Light friend. I got all your shirts, Mark. This isn't one of them, but I got them. And I'm proud to say that you sent me larges, and I was wearing 2x extra larges for some time. But since my my procedure and all that, and having to go around in the walker and whatever, I've lost 22 pounds. So your shirts fit fine. I just don't happen to be wearing one right now because this is a work shirt, and your shirts are too nice for work. So thank you, Mark. The other thing, on a personal level, today's Friday. What is it, the 18th or whatever, something like that. And I did not get my prosthetic leg today. I went in, great disappointment. Somebody messed up at the office, said my leg was ready. I went in there and all they did was a plaster casting of it. So I have to wait till next week, probably around Tuesday, the 20th, I believe, the 21st or something. And so today was a bummer that way. So I decided to make a video, make myself feel better. So pure technique video, no funny on this or whatever. I don't have the time because Mama Smurf is probably going to kill me in my sleep if I keep going much longer. So enjoy the procedure, unlike mine, and watch what I did. And remember, I'm going to speed this up because, you know, the film took almost an hour. It takes about 40 minutes to 50 minutes to pluck all the bottoms one, but do it carefully and correctly. Also realize that there is going to be some razor edges like there was on top. And the next video, I'm going to show you how I sanded down that top. I showed you raised tiles, but that was right after painting, before the enamel had a chance to shrink. It also gets soft sanded. And a lot of people were questioning me, saying, well, why aren't you doing the 5-color layout and all that? Well, at first I was considering not doing it, but a lot of people were going, well, you probably can't do it. Well, on you. Yes, I can. I've done it. So what I am going to do is included a 4th pass of color to get that 5-color thing. I'm going to create some templates with some help or by myself. And I am going to do the 5-color thing with the scarab little extra details that were all over the motion picture one before they literally sanded it down visually or with CG or whatever. And I'm going to give my client the absolute motion picture reproduction, the best that I can do. So you will be seeing that. I am going to do it. And all you guys have said, you probably can't do it. You can go yourselves. You know what I'm saying? So anyways, let's move on. Thank you.